There is nothing like the glory of parenthood. I used to be pro-choice. It wasn't because I was evil. It wasn't because I wanted to murder babies. It was because I was an impressionable child who was taught the wrong thing. Because I went through the public school system and I learned that it was a clump of cells. And that just could not be further from the truth. I was astonished, and I was already brought over to the side of pro-life. And I still remember seeing the ultrasound. My son was 11 weeks old. I will never forget that moment of him dancing, his arms, his legs, and doing this move. And I just started breaking down crying, and I was just crying because his personality was so clear to me, and it's still what his personality is today. I think that the pro-choice movement has become so radicalized that even people that are pro-choice don't identify with this. When we were having this debate even 5 years ago, we weren't talking about 9 months in the womb being able to abort a child. That's unfathomable. They are increasingly radical, but I personally think that our society is becoming increasingly more conservative because it's gotten so radical, because we went from, up to 12 weeks this should be allowed, and then now we've landed on, even if, you know, it's a botched abortion and the baby is still breathing, it should be murdered. We're talking about infanticide, and that is human sacrifice, the likes of which haven't been seen since the Aztec Empire, and that's scary. We have abortion laws that are in line with North Korea. Have we ever wanted, is that where our society should be? Should we be in line with North Korea? The media narrative running around telling Black Americans that they are unsafe on the streets, that they are unsafe in the presence of a police officer, that they are unsafe in the presence of white people. And I say, actually, if you are a Black American, the most unsafe place for you is in your mother's womb. And that's the truth, right? Is in your mother's womb. How sad is that? That is where you are most likely to be killed. That is where you are most likely to have your life taken from you. You cannot deny what is plainly in front of your face. And so ultrasounds should be a requirement for any woman that is considering getting an abortion. It destroys the lie with such magnitude that you can't come back from it. I always say that people that have made those mistakes can always be the biggest, most important advocates for the truth. It's for women that have gotten abortions, and I said this on stage, don't feel like you have to then become a voice for the left's evil and say, well, because I've done this, I now feel compelled that this is the only space that I can be accepted in. It's as a pro-abortion advocate. That's not true. You could be an anti-abortion advocate, and your voice would have more weight because you went through it. And I had received this past week tons of emails from girls who heard that message and received it and said, I cried the whole time I was getting this abortion. I cried after it. I still have doubts about it. And these are young women, and hearing you just say that I don't have to be an advocate for this, something that hurt me, was something that they needed to hear. So I am always saying to those women that don't feel like you have to be pigeonholed, and that one thing that you do in your life has to determine the rest of your life. It's one of the great lies of our society that you're not allowed to evolve, you're not allowed to change your mind. And so that is why I think linking arms with advocates that have had abortions and having them talk about that horror that they still experience, that regret that they experience, can be very helpful in combating these more radical arguments that are arriving. I would say every second of every single day becomes a defining moment and a defining argument, I would say, for the pro-life movement when you have a child. You are just amazed at the miracle of life, just seeing the things that take place through your son's eyes and the growth that happens every day trying something new. I mean, I just cannot advocate for having a family more. I cannot be more pro-family. If I'm radical, I'm radically pro-family. I think it just does something to the spirit of a woman. Women become what they were meant to become. It is a superpower unlocked, is truly what it is.